hear of a guy by the name of Thomas Piketty? P-I-K-E-T-T-Y, Thomas Piketty? You haven't? The president has. The Democrat leadership has. Democrat columnists and spokesmen have heard of him. Thomas Piketty is a French economist. He's a hardcore socialist. And he's in favor with Democrats in this country. That is, Democrats who are decision makers and opinion makers. And he has a new book out, and he's traveling all over the country, our country. And he's linked to the French Socialist Party. He's very popular in Democrat circles in this country. And his fundamental argument is that modern-day capitalism leads to unsustainable levels of inequality. You've heard Obama and the others say essentially the same thing, without the capitalism part, but that's what they mean. And this book is called Capital in the 21st Century. It's being hawked by Paul Krugman, who's a nut job at the New York Slimes. And his book tour in the United States, he has met with White House Council of Economic Advisors, as well as Treasury Secretary Jacob Lew, hat tip gateway pundit for bringing this to light. And this guy Piketty told the French press agency in Washington, the Democratic Party, especially the Obama administration, has been in contact with us and using our findings for a long time, quote unquote. Now, 20 years ago, this would have been big news. Today, nobody gives a damn. They just don't care. Now, in his book, he warns that free market economies will see ever-growing concentration of wealth in the hands of those who already hold capital. That's interesting. I see ever-growing concentration of wealth in the federal government, whether it's land, assets of other sorts, a big percentage of your income, borrowing. It's not the free market it's the problem. It's the government that's concentrating wealth. He says when the rate of return on capital exceeds the rate of growth of output and income as it did in the 19th century and seems quite likely to do in the 21st, capitalism automatically generates arbitrary and unsustainable inequalities that radically undermine the meritocratic values on whether democratic societies on which democratic societies are based. This is nonsense. We saw this during the Reagan era. Massive job growth, massive wealth creation, new enterprises popping up everywhere, inventions, productivity, services, and so forth and so on. This is just wrong. Let me explain to my satisfaction, or hopefully yours anyway, what's actually going on isn't there's too much concentration of capital in the private sector. What's actually going on is the government's at war with the private sector. There's not enough capital generally in the private sector. Now, this guy argues that in the long run, earnings from possessions such as property and financial assets grow faster than the rest of the economy, especially wages. This, he warns, leads to deepening inequalities with serious social consequences. And we heard this claptrap from the Fabian socialists over one century ago as well, ladies and gentlemen.